He's been with the company for quite some time, from the chrysalis as well, at him today. Kovas is one of those people that is very particular. You know, you think that he doesn't talk, but hey, the jokes, you know, he's the jokes, he says something, and you're like, oh, serious, is it you? But that's him. So when you see him, if I don't think he doesn't. So those guys at the table there, guys, be prepared to get all the jokes, of course. And if you don't catch it, you'll see the jokes. Table number 16, Neo. I see Neo is standing up, he's not sitting down. Table number 17, last but not least, we got Uncle Max.
So that was the team, and those were what I see for us as well, and I saw Anthony as well. But that's the team, support team, which are helping us you know, from a business perspective. Now we're going to move on. I'm going to introduce somebody. A very key person today, somebody we appreciate a lot in this business, somebody who never holds grudges, somebody who's tough but very nice. He's the chairperson of this and that company. He has been chairpersons throughout, but this individual, the way he's so approachable, the way he's so humble, you know, some of the things you won't even know about him. You only get by accidentally get to know, oh, but I didn't know that this is you. I didn't know that you have achieved this much. And that is how humble he is. He doesn't talk about those kind of things. You get, as I said, you get to know about those things by chance. But this individual is very key to us, and we appreciate you.
I wish to thank Ms. Sani for opening this occasion in prayer. Also wish to thank the management, the Daybreak, especially the HR people for organizing such a prestigious event to honor all of you as our guest of honor. Also thank you, Marcela, for those wise words, kind words that you have said about me. And I'm also glad that you didn't say the bad things about me, because nobody's perfect. We all have our shortcomings and we have our strengths, and it's important to acknowledge both. This occasion shows how we as Daybreak appreciate you as our employees. You are an important stakeholder. So don't look down upon yourself. You have played a very important role in the sustainability of our business. And with that, I wish you to clap hands for yourselves. Service is not an easy period. I know that sometimes we are very angry with us, and sometimes we did appreciate the good things that we did for you. And this period of 10 years shows very much that you are very loyal employees of Daybreak. And you are an example that all of us need to follow, and we appreciate you for doing that. You have been with us through it all during the difficult times. Matilda has spoken about those times when we are unable to pay your salaries, until this a little bit of good times that we have, because now it is we are able to pay you without asking anybody to give us money. I must also acknowledge that you have contributed positively to the turnaround of Daybreak. The turnaround was not brought by me, it was brought by all of us. You actually stretched yourself, you had to produce more goods, you had to work hard, and that is highly appreciated. So there's no one person who can change an organization. So we did all of us, and with that we were highly appreciative. We are also very hardworking. I must say, when I go to the abattoirs, when I go to the farms, actually I find people working and working very hard, which shows that you are indeed loyal to this organization. And I also like your attitude, which is positive, because in most organizations there's always a fight between management and the employees, but the spirit at Daybreak is very humbling, because we interact in a good manner. I was surprised at some point when there was a strike at Delmas, and I went to the gate, and the gate was locked, and the striking employees were angry that I was locked out. They were like, "Hey, Bulani, now you can free." I was shocked because I thought maybe these guys are going to chase me, but they were like angry to say, "How can you know?" So that shows the kind of people that we have. And they think we can fight, but we still respect each other. Now, what is very important also is the teamwork, because we don't need to compete. An organization grows and becomes better because we work together. If we compete, we must compete with our competitors outside, but not with employees. We work together, we help each other to become better, because if we do that, then we can achieve more if we work together than if we work on our own competing. So teamwork is very important. Now, as an organization going forward, there are things that we want to do for you. And I think at some point, Buku and Matela and our colleagues will come and share those things with you, because they're quite important, because we cannot as an organization only receive and receive without giving back. So we need to also give back to you, because the sustainability of an organization is about its people and how an organization takes care of its important stakeholder, which are the employees. Now, there's a program that is very close to my heart. It's called Employee Wellness Program. Some people call it EAP. It's a program where we need to assist you, because you are not a machine. As you are here, you have your own issues. Some of you work very hard, 10 years. What happens to you on the 11th year? You get sick. And then we don't want to send you home. We really want you to work with us and try to give you the work that can accommodate you. And I know most of us here, we are suffering under abomasyonis, but still the demand. So we need to have our experts who can come and talk about personal management, how to budget, you know. Even if you earn less, you can still survive. You know, because I know how much I'm getting a figure out my mission is. It's terrible. 10,000 you put for 10 years. So we cannot afford really to go there. So personal financial management, we need to come and talk to you about it. You know, Mrs. Kati, people think wellness talks about, you know, we are a little bit. Sometimes people are depressed. Sometimes people have a lot of tension, anxiety. So we need to have a situation where when you have those challenges, you can speak to your employer or someone confidentially who's going to talk to you, and then who's going to keep that information. I think we tell about the stress, anything will be, and the faculty will be. So you have to go and talk to someone who understands the psychologist, who can actually help you. We also need to help our young people, because for example, we have a situation in our country where people are frustrated. We need to come and speak as Mate, who can tell us how to be good husbands, how to be good men. How can we be good fathers? I mean, so that when we are like that, we become happy. So those are the things that we want to do in our wellness. The other project that is very important is what we call e-talent management. We are gifted differently, right? Talent management means we need to identify people. Like, for instance, why we celebrate here for that you are 10 years? Some of you have been working in the same situation for all these years. No promotion, nothing. So we need to start to identify people and come with our programs that will actually make them better for promotion. We don't want, you know, Masila is getting very old, and I'm old now, and I'm over. So at some point, we have to leave this organization. Who's going to take over? It must be one of you sitting here. So talent management means we must identify you, how you work, your attitude, to be able to groom you so that when the time comes, not only for the CEO position or executive, even for the supervisor. You see, Mike is also getting tired and he also wants to be replaced. So we don't want people from outside. So talent management, it means we identify people from within and groom them and train them to ensure that they can take over, stay another 10 years in this organization. Thank you.
Thanks for those words of encouragement, and as they say, there is a silver lining here in the tunnel, and that is what we was talking about. So all the projects that I can sitting there, and the student now is exposing us, from the HR department, he has been pushing for all those things he's talking about. He is very, very passionate about us having those systems in place as a company. And I saw see such things. So I was like, well, that is the one question before me. We are supposed to go on meet morning break, which is 30 minutes. Guys, I'm going to ask that we stick to the time because our lunch is at 2 o'clock. The CEO, the CFO, for a meeting outside with the auditors, so we're going to meet our books to say why did not make money, what happened to the money that I'm joking. But we need to push, so what I'm going to ask is that to be, I don't know what's too late, if you don't mind taking to better for me, please. And by the way, I told Tumbeto and they are today's commanders, they are the captains, not me. So if you see the ship going down, you don't blame me, just look at them. Give them cards. So I'm going to, now please keep, Tumbe, are we okay? 2 minutes. 10 minutes. Okay, so we're going to, in terms of the program, I'm going to just change it a little bit. We are going to have that new community, and I need to apologize because I thought when we got here, we were going to arrive here, we're going to have some snacks, and I think there was that miscommunication. However, we're going to have a new community. When we come back, in terms of the program, I'm going to ask the few managers again, I'm going to change, but I'll tell you when we come back properly. We're going to change, and we'll reschedule how we're going to do the photo shooting. Because of the numbers, as I said, we would wish for each and every individual to come and stand with the CEO alone and take a picture. But because of the numbers, we are very tired, so we'll do it a little bit different from how we usually do it. But you'll still have a picture with the CEO, so keep on smiling. And besides the photos, guys, there's a video going around, so they might be recording you. So don't stand sleep, my brother. Okay, guys, I'm going to ask us to break, and then when we come back, can I ask that we be seated promptly, Ghana? If we can go and move by 12 o'clock, I think it's almost 11:30. As I said, the bathroom is in Kamola. 12 o'clock, yeah, I hope better. So, is it where we're going to have the tea break? Or tea break is here? Lunch is the side.
The other bathrooms.
Yes. Okay, and then the system?
Yes.
Okay, so the bathrooms, the other ones are this side. I think most of you went to this once, but then as my brother is saying, the other ones are this side. Just walk through here and then we can go. Please, guys, can I once again request that we behave, and I'm saying behave, we need better commas. Let's not take the things you should not be able to ask, please. We are day breakers. We don't do those things. So can I add that you can go talk about me and then we can sit here. Thank you.
And I mean it. I'm the CEO of Daybreak. We gathered here to honor our employees who spend 10 years in service. So today we have what we call long service awards for our employees. So it's a way of an organization saying thank you to them for being loyal for all these years to the organization and for contributing positively to the sustainability of the business.
Edwin Sodi from Delmas plant, Daybreak.
How long have you been working for Daybreak?
It's 10 years.
And how's Daybreak treated you?
Very, very good. A good environment to work. I'm thinking I'm like to work at Daybreak. In fact, if I can call it. Because, you know, we've got good team, especially on coming to management side, it's very good. With workers too, we communicate very well. We just mingle very well with workers and management.
I'm going to call your names. How's that? It's gonna be pretty interesting. You don't take the table number one. Where's the one, by the way?
A decade of working at Daybreak. And like Gugu alluded to earlier this morning, you still look all very beautiful. I wish to congratulate you guys on an important achievement in your lives. To me, it speaks about character, dedication, and loyalty. All very good qualities to have. Not only in the work situation, but in life. I don't want to forget something. People are and will always be a very big asset for any company. That's why you are a valuable member to Daybreak. Your abilities and contributions are what is what make Daybreak successful. I want to take this opportunity to thank you for your hard work and dedication. And look forward to another 10 years working together. Thank you.
Number two, I'm going to call Anandi Martin Chinedi. The first person is Matangu. Vusi Moses Matangu.
And you'll be confused at the end.
That's the last table. I've got to do Prudence Kosi.
This day belongs to you. Lastly, I just want to thank Mr. Sirulubi, the executive team, for doing this for us. And I think the people see this. We appreciate it. Thanks a lot for doing this.